Emmett? Where'd you take him now, Doc?
Next up on our roster, a man who saw the possibilities in pond scum. Welcome, Ernest Philpot!
Thanks, Trixie, Technie. I'm truly honored to be here today among all you pointy-headed type people. Like the lady said, I labor in the field of pond scum. Algae, ladies and gentlemen, is a mysterious and little-known biological entity. Through diligent study and countless...
I don't even like algae cakes, but free samples are free samples.
...the secrets of this noble vegetable, and I am here to present my discoveries to a disbelieving world.
Excuse me, sir. I'm looking for a tall, thin, older gentleman. He might have been with a tall, thin, younger gentleman.
I know just who you're talking about. Hey, you're slow. About a minute ago. If you hurry, you might pass.
Till now, people haven't been getting the benefit of all this nutrition.
I know you're in there, Doc.
Doc. Sweetened with corn syrup, and held together in solid blocks through the miracle of American.
Quit fooling around, Doc. What have you done with
that?
Sonny! What are you doing? You can't assault the exhibitors!
You don't understand. He's kidnapped Emmett.
The boy is obviously confusing.
I'll say he is.
You want I should toss him out on his ear?
That won't be necessary. Do you know who that is? That's Jacques Duteau of the Oceanic Institute.
No, it's not. It's...
Please keep it down. The Expo went through a lot of trouble and expense to secure Professor Duteau. We can't afford to antagonize him.
But
if you've got a complaint against him, we can straighten it out after the show. But if you make another scene like that, I'm afraid I'm gonna have you expelled from the hall.
Where'd you stash Emmett? In the diving bell?
It's called a bathysphere.
Aha! So Emmett is in the bathysphere.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You're not gonna get away with this, you know.
As they say in my country, que sera, sera.
Thank you, Ernest. Do be sure to drop by his booth and sample an algae cake. I have, and it was very interesting. I will be back later to highlight another of our fine exhibitors. See you soon!
Hey, Jacques. Why don't you tell me who you really are?
Pardon, seafood's plate. I do not accept flowers from no strangers.
Okay. Call me a snoop.
Welcome to the world of tomorrow, where a man's home is truly his castle. Here, gratification is just always a push of a button away. In the house of the future, phone conversations will be completed in the privacy of the personal phone helmet.
Please recite the phone number you wish to dial. Or say, hang up, to terminate your phone helmet experience.
Klondike 4253.
Jeez, always with the phones. Yeah?
It's me, Carl.
Oh, hi, Mr. Sagan. What can I do for you?
Can you get Edna on the phone for me again?
You got it, Mr. Sagan. Hey, Your Highness!
Mr. Sagan, you really have to stop calling me like this. I've got to keep all of my attention on Detective Parker.
Yes, yes, of course. I've just got a couple more questions. Regarding, you know what?
You know what?
The little matter we were whispering about yesterday.
Oh, that! As a matter of fact, I'm glad you brought it up. I was thinking, wouldn't it be a good idea to pin it all on Yakov Smirnov?
Pin what on him, exactly?
You know, it! Oh, I get it. You're still sore about going to jail. That was the dog's fault. If he hadn't come glumping up to me right after I started the fire, I could have gotten clean away, and I never would have had to divert suspicion to you.
She's the speakeasy arsonist.
Carl, is somebody with you?
No, it's just you and me. You know, I don't think I ever asked you why you burned down all those speakeasies.
Why? Because no one else was doing anything about them. Every night they'd open up their doors serving illegal drinks and loose women, flaunting their depravity to the world, and the authorities did nothing. So I did what any right-thinking, rock-willed woman would do. I took action. Oh, and such a gorgeous action it was, too. The fires were so beautiful. The alcohol made them go up in such pretty blue flames. Where was I?
You were explaining why you burned down the speakeasies.
Yes. Did you find my answer to your liking?
It was very revealing. Hang up.
What?
Jeez, Edna was always a loon. I hope that confession's good enough for Parker.
The next exhibitor on our list is Officer Danny Parker of the Hill Valley Police Force. Officer Parker is going to demonstrate a few of the many marvelous tools that our boys in blue will soon have at their disposal. The criminal element has truly met his match today. Officer Parker? It seems our next exhibitor is unavoidably detained, but I'm sure his presentation would have been both enlightening and exciting. How about a round of applause just for the heck of it?
A lot of people are going to be interested in that answer.
Well, speak of the devil.
Hey, Danny.
Do you mind, comrade? We're busy trying to protect the Expo from the likes of you.
This'll only take a minute.
Our plant recorder. It's not a good idea to steal police property, you know.
Shh, listen.
You know, I don't think I ever asked you why you burned down all those speakeasies.
Why? Because no one else was doing anything about them.
Detective Parker, surely you're not going to believe this crudely manufactured forgery of a recording.
I'm not sure what to believe, ma'am. But based on this crudely manufactured forgery, I'm afraid I'm going to have to ask you to come down to the station to answer a few questions about your whereabouts on the night of the speakeasy fires.
Oh, very well. Heavens, what's that?
You know, one of these days I should really stop falling for that.
Hey, does this mean that the barricades can come down from Emmett's booth? Let's take that as a yes. Nice of Trixie to give me these tickets. They're supposed to get me into all the big attractions. Are you ready for a picture radio? Wonder if that's anything like MTV. The electro pacifier. An electric stun gun would be pretty useful, but this is just a model. Here's my ticket. I want to see inside that bathysphere.
I don't think so.
What do you mean? I've got a ticket. You have to honor my ticket.
It's the wrong kind of ticket. Sorry.
Oh, give me a break.
Algae cakes taste so good you'd swear they was bad for you.
Hey, Artie.
What do you think? Quite a setup, huh?
The Expo? Sure. But I was wondering, this ticket should get me into any exhibit on the floor, right?
Sure, that's a P-ticket.
Well, the guy at the aquarium is refusing to honor it.
There must be some mistake. Come on, let's straighten this out. Professor Duteau, this young man claims you refused to take his ticket.
Not at all. I am only too happy to take his ticket. Please, climb the ladder. And I will raise the bathysphere. Mon Dieu, what is the matter? The gears, they must have become stuck. I am afraid I cannot raise the bathysphere at this moment.
What a shame.
Yes, it is. Well, I will work on that problem. Perhaps if you come back later. Come down, please. The bathysphere exhibit is currently closed for repairs.
I'll wait.
Hiya, folks. It's me, Techni, Muse of Progress, gracing you once again with my presence. And speaking of presents, what better gift could Hill Valley offer the world than this magnificent science and technology exhibit, hey folks? If you haven't done so already, I urge each and every one of you to take a peek at Furnishings of the Future, right here in our main hall. Tickets are available from me, Techni, at our information desk.
It may be quite some time before the exhibit is fixed.
I'm not going anywhere.
Come down, please. The bathysphere exhibit is currently closed for repairs.
I'll wait.
Step back! You're crimping the hose!
What does it matter if there's nobody in the bathysphere?
It's very bad form.
Oh, sorry.
It's an old nautical superstition. A crimped horse needs doom.
It does if there's somebody inside the bathysphere, but I thought you said there wasn't anybody in the bathysphere.
There's not. I command you, uncrimp that horse!
Funny, you'd think it was you who was running out of air, not the guy in the bathysphere.
I don't know what you're talking about.
It's as if you two were connected somehow.
Step off the horse!
Raise the bathysphere, Doc.
I walked to it!
Then neither will I.
to the lords, the years that they have become unstuck.
There, see? It was just a malfunction after all.
Let's get you out of there.
Emmett Brown? Then it was true. Hey, you.
Hey, he just took that guy's wallet. I think he took his wallet.
Oh, remind me not to become an oceanographer. I guess I must have a touch of claustrophobia. Never should have gone in there.
Well, we've all got problems. Now, you'd better get back to your booth.
Funny thing is, I don't even remember going in there. Last thing I recall, I was in the glass house talking to Carl Sagan. Did you know he's really a scientist?
I'd heard. What did he say to you?
Oh, he had some sort of spur-of-the-moment business proposition. It was all very rush-rush. I never got the details. It would have meant leaving before the expo was over, so I told him that... Say, where'd he go? Do you know?
Carl Sagan? He had to leave. One of his experiments blew up on him.
Nah, I know how that is.
Greetings and salutations to all our honored guests. I am Techni, Muse of Progress, and it is my pleasant task once again to highlight one of the great minds who was hard at work building a better tomorrow.
I think that's me. I'm next on the roster.
But are you ready?
No, I don't have a choice. Did you bring the static accumulator?
Oh, right. Here you go.
Great. Come on, let's get up there.
And banging them together in his garage. And who knows, one of this kid's gizmos just might take off and change the life of everybody in town. Could it be the very thing he's brought to share with us today? This wouldn't be the first time the world was changed by a kid barely out of
that ought to do it. Are the block bearings all in the raised position?
Block bearings. Raised position, check.
Then it looks like all systems are gold.
She was only 19.
Wish me luck.
Don't have to.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Emmett Brown!
Objection! Objection, Your Honor! I hereby demand that the scientific demonstration of one Emmett Lethra Brown be terminated and forfeit by reason of insanity! I declare him to be in contempt of me, his father! Where is he? Hand him over this instant! The longer you hold out, the harder it's going to be for you!